recently got a webcam specifically for streaming, as well as a gooseneck table set, which is still coming on its way. Oh no, this is mostly for why I planned for next year. Basically, I've been stocking up on a lot of Warhammer stuff. And also I'm going to be painting them on stream. Painting competition at the store. You can see what I've been up to with on the Discord. Still got 30 minutes.
I was hovering over it and my finger clicked. I'm sorry.
How could you, demon?
I'm sorry. I haven't started my thingy bob yet, so let me know when you go to your page.
Yeah, I'm already on my page.
Oh, okay. In that case, hello, hello. We are doing Tales of Lost Souls, Act 1. I am going to be your DM tonight. Well, it's night for us, I guess. Demon. I am joined with Neza.
Greetings.
Patron.
Hello, everybody. I am your overseer.
Chaos.
Yo.
And Sage.
What up?
Now, there is a... Depending on what happens, I will not suffer.
You'll always suffer, demon.
You
come
always
on.
Suffer.
I know, right? Also, just before I forget, after D&D, like, part is done, if you're watching this as a VOD, there may still be a bit more, because I may end up doing... My mic isn't working. Hold on. Hello.
Hello.
Technical difficulties.
I mean, I had them yesterday, and now they work completely fine.
Like, it's not picking up my mic whatsoever. What the fuck?
What do you mean it's not picking up your mic? Hold on.
We can hear you.
Can you hear me from my stream?
Hold on. We hear you.
You hear me from a stream?
I mean, I did before I had to mute it, because I forgot to mute it.
Here, I'm going to mute Discord and let me know if you can hear me through stream and chat or something, okay?
Sure.
Omega Ray Tommy. Well, it isn't...
I can hear you. Yeah, I can hear you
through the stream.
Yeah, Omega says they can also hear me. That is going to really piss me off since it's not flashing. thank you, Omega. Jesus Christ. Coming.
Fun. He's already broken.
But yeah, may end up doing a bit of lethal company with some of my other friends. May end up streaming it. So I'm just giving you a heads up.
Yeah.
And with that, we've also finished. Thank you, Omega. Yes, I am indeed loading as I can't process this glitch. just a heads up from what we did off screen. We... Thank you for the hashtag, the scratch mark hail. We did Sage's trade with Blacksmith. So they sold some stuff.
Yeah.
And bought a new piece of armor.
And financially broke.
Yeah, so I'm now going to close out of this journal because I've added a couple useful but not so much on the way of powerful items. Because on the off chance you're struggling to figure out what type of magical items I'm in, I figure it's not going to hurt to have, like, a table.
Yeah. If you guys also want to, like, look at stuff that you think would be, like, beneficial or, like, things that you're looking for, as in, like, equipment-wise or magical items or something, and add it as, like, a list into your journals as well. Because if I give out loot, I can decide, I can go, oh, this actually doesn't look too bad, I'll give you this at this point, or... make a quest item, or figure out where I can add it into the story.
Yeah, so I've also put the rarity of the items next to them as well, so you can basically always look up what rarities if you're looking for specific rarities too.
Nice.
Thank you. But yeah, if you guys want to add that to like your journals as well, feel free to do so, because I can use it as a reference. But yes...
But yeah, so if you were to suddenly be like, you know what, everyone has items on their list, my armor class is going to be like an effective 40 plus.
I'll just have to start throwing some tresks at you, that's all.
Do you want us to start like another journal for that, or just put on one of
no,
the
No, just add a new page.
To which one?
In your personal journals.
Okay, so what should we
do? Oh, okay.
So if I quickly...
And also any reports that I make in-game for roleplay purposes, I will also be making new pages for them as well, so the DM can reference them whenever they wish to.
Yeah,
I've been making like small notes because it's like, play as a scholar. It makes sense for me to write down some stuff like.
It also, in case if I make a mistake in recalling something, it also helps me to go, oh yeah, I did say this.
I mean, isn't that just our job, and we're just supposed to do it verbally instead of you reading it?
Yeah, but I can also check at any time, and it lets me plan ahead.
It takes all the fun out of it, though.
Yeah, but I have to make maps for this game.
Yeah, you've got to make the maps, you've got to make the encounters, maybe I want to throw the players a bone, and you're not painstakingly look for something that could be useful to the group. You can just flip to someone's journal and be like, I feel like giving this person a magical item, and you can take a look at the list.
Yeah, and also, some items I have to write in myself. So it just helps me being prepared.
You know I'm just screwing you around, right?
Yeah, I know. I'm just letting you know. Thank you for the hail. And the hydrate. But yes. We technically finished up with the blacksmith group last time. So if we want to start with the military group. AKA Neza.
Okay.
Over to the military.
So if I remember correctly, I sort of came in here to requisition a replacement of some of the supplies that I've used when handing in some reports.
Yes. They have gotten all these supplies to the best of their abilities. The paper isn't as good as the paper you had before, but it's pretty much usable. And they hand you a little rucksack filled with these supplies that you've asked for. You can decide to take them out or keep the rucksack.
I'll take the items out of the rucksack and I'll hand them back saying that I've got my own bags on me. I'll leave this here on the off chance someone else has more need of it.
For that, they thank you, since it takes a while for them to get new supplies from the capital.
Yeah, there might be a few things that I'm looking at getting at some type of mark if there's one in this town. Are we low on anything in our stocks?
In your stocks?
Well, our stocks as in the guardsmen stocks, the soldier stocks.
At the moment, one of them takes a moment to think, and he says, at the moment, we're pretty all right. It is coming up to a time where we start sending out a request for new shipment and supplies to the capital city of this domain. But at the moment, we have not seemed to burn through as many items as we anticipated.
Very well. I hope that they basically have everything that is required from the shipments. In any case, I will continue on with my duties because I have a group to try and track down.
Very well, sir. We wish your journey to be walked with speed and honor.
To use as well, and I'll give them sort of like a bow before heading back out the building.
They salute you, and one salutes and one gives you a slight bow. Since they're not sure on which customs you believe in, they decide to do both.
How polite.
Well, either or, I'm not too picky because I didn't ask which one's more common.
It's like, make up your damn minds.
Okay, so, like that to get out of the room. And then, would there be an investigation check to see if there are any types of mundane item stalls?
In this, I'm going to let you know that there is a market in this town. If you take, like, 5-ish minutes, literally, from your location, you'd find it anyway. It is just down and to the right.
I mean, I could assume it was, but I don't think my character's seen them yet.
There are signs around the place.
Okay, so that would be the place I would be heading to.
Very well.
As you're saying, it'll take me about 5 minutes to walk down there, so feel free to continue with the other people. I'll stop myself here.
Do that, so I don't have to move my other screen around. So, we come back to the blacksmith group. As far as I'm aware, we've did go through everyone. I'm not sure about you, Katron. Did we end up doing you? Or were you not doing anything?
We did do some things for me. Hold on.
I can just quickly go up chat. We did seem to have a trade.
We did do a trade, yeah.
Well, in that case, the blacksmith would first inquire with you, Yurik, and Nash, if there's any other business that is required of him, as if you want to sell anything else or buy anything.
Ooh, interesting question.
Hmm.
And while you're having this ponder, I will just mention to Chaos what he's going to mention to you. He's going to ask if you need anything or have brought back any special material.
Yes, I do ask. Is that me asking the blacksmith?
That's him asking you if you have any material that you want to sell, since he remembers he has that deal with you.
I believe Ulrich has a crystal from the cultist place.
I did
that we might want you
few.
To have a look at.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you discern what this is as I hand one of them over?
He the blacksmith takes the crystals that you show him. He says, "Oh, it's been a while since I've seen one of these. They can be used in a magical component. Not that common, but not entirely rare. They're mostly used in crushing up and making into powder to draw magic circles."
Ah, so like a catalyst?
Yes. Yeah. They are more they have more magic conductivity than other types of crystals, but it's still not the best type there is out in the market.
Okay, but the cultists we found had a massive stockpile of them.
When they
say
do,
if
common,
get enough of
rather
a common
them.
I mean, if you get enough of the common stuff, then you'll be able to do anything.
Yes, and not only that, our kingdom actually has more mines of this stuff than most other kingdoms.
Ah, that would make sense.
But so, this is of low quality as well, so it's more common, from what I can see. It also doesn't have the best as the better equipped ones.
But we can still sell it for more if we do it in another kingdom, right?
Probably so, because it is lower quality. But if you find any of the higher quality ones, you could probably still sell them here for quite a hefty profit. Even this one here could end up getting you about 10-ish gold pieces.
Oh, we should have grabbed a whole bunch.
Keep in mind, if you start selling too much in one spot in our kingdom, though, it can affect its price.
True.
Question.
Yes.
Can that be used to craft anything with? Like enhancements or something like that?
Yeah, you'd think if you grind it into dust, then forge it into a weapon, it would make the weapon more conductive for magic?
I wouldn't be able to do that with this material here, but what you could probably do though is if you take it to the as he gestures out in a direction, I'll just ping this direction. If you head over in that direction, there's a little hut just down the road. There is a lady there who specializes more in magic than I do, and may be able to use it as a way to maybe enchant something. I don't know. Or maybe try and make a magical item for you.
We could all use some enhancements.
Just keep in mind, it's not the best, and it probably won't succeed unless you have almost 2 tons of it. That's how ineffective this version is.
Do the more effective versions have different colors to them?
Some of them do, depending on how they've grown, and as a result, they have better affinity with other elements.
Ah, so they were used to summon demons or devils. What color would they be?
If you're using it as a circle, you could pretty much use any color. But the color that you'd probably want with the circle, again, I'm not an expert. I'm only going after knowledge that I have gained from travel buys.
Oh, that's
fine. Apparently, it is the color of your affinity. So if you have a better affinity for water, you'd want one that has a good affinity with water.
How will we know our affinities?
That I can't help you. Only specialized devices would be able to tell you that.
And you know where we'll be able to get tested? For fucking
maybe
rabies.
Maybe either in the capital, or maybe even rarer in the capital of this domain. I wouldn't know.
I do have one more thing I could show you that I'm curious about.
Yes.
I show my steel mirror and say, is this just an ordinary steel mirror? I found it in the cultist hideout. It was rather well hidden. Not sure what to do with it, though.
To me, it's a steel mirror. If you take it to a magic shop, they might be able to check.
Okay, thank you. Is there a magic shop in town?
He gestures in the same direction.
Okay.
She deals in more magic stuff than I do, but it's not truly a shop.
Okay.
It's like an advisor.
Yes. She more deals in predicting of the weather for the ships are leaving the harbor.
Oh, useful.
Well, could you by any chance point us in the direction of a place that actually deals in magic items?
There wouldn't be one in this town.
Yeah, it's too small for that.
Like I said, you're more looking for a big town, or a city, or the capital.
That makes sense, because most of the people who can afford magic items will be in those places.
The only kingdom in this world that would have a magic shop in every town would be the Kingdom of Magic.
Got it in the name now, isn't it?
I know, right?
Bit on the nose, though, if you ask me.
Hey... It's a kingdom that floats in the sky. What do you expect?
Touche.
Now I really want to go there. A sky island? That sounds like a paradise.
It's multiple islands.
Okay, a sky archipelago.
Yeah, well, first
you'll be able to go there once you unlock your ship.
We need a key for that.
Mm-hmm.
You need to get to the end of Arc 1 for that.
True.
Oh, that's what the log pits are for.
That's what time skips for, bitch. Final boss next room. Oh my god.
Time skip to the end of the chapter.
A final boss. A locked door.
No. And then after that, it's a chair in the center of the room. It does nothing. My people are scared of it.
Yes. Because it is set of housed the ramp of the most evilest being in the world.
Wow.
Glutinous Maximus.
Oh, please.
Oh, my God. Well, then. Is there anything else you need me for?
I'm pretty much covered.
Nah.
Yeah.
You got any better armors that don't exactly weigh me down? Because seriously, this stuff is good, but I need something a little tougher.
How do you improve your decks?
From what I have here, it's going to weigh you down. I would suggest maybe heading to a bigger town or a city. There, they may be able to enhance the armor.
It seems like everything we need is in a city or a bigger town.
This is a starting village. What do you expect?
I don't know. I expect you guys to have a little more stuff going on, seriously.
Hey, this is a trade port. Most of their stuff goes to bigger towns and cities. That's where the most of their income comes in.
Yeah, touche, but considering that most goods come past free here, you think it'd be a little more busier?
It's mostly food.
We used to be busier until the city down by the bay, down the way. I would say probably about half a month's journey from here, opened up.
A bigger trade.
So that's a business.
Yeah. It's also one of the biggest export places in the entire kingdom heading south.
Shit. I don't know. What do you need to get back on your feet, more or less?
I make my due, as you can tell, as he gestures to where you've probably stocked your coins.
That's fair.
Yeah. Well, pleasure doing business. Thank you for the armor.
Very well.
Thanks for having us.
Any points you cast, don't forget our deal.
I won't.
As we go, we'll walk out as the chaos is spinning around in a circle.
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah.
You don't want to go to this door, which is easier to exit and leave.
I didn't even pay attention to that.
You expect the players to take the easy way out?
I know.
What do you expect?
Oh, he got out fine.
Now, before you guys continue moving on, I will go back to Nez.
So I would have spent the past 5 minutes sort of wandering around, taking the sights of the town. What have I taken in?
So you have taken in a couple of temporary housing places, the guild, a few rundown houses, the warehouses, the places you've already been, somewhat of a general store, and you will have found the marketplace, which you're currently standing in front of.
In front of? I'm in front of the the military place.
It's a bit more further.
That's the entrance to the marker.
To be honest, I thought that was like more of a back way, and the entrance would have been like up here.
No, that's how they get carts in and out.
I mean, this is an open market, so anywhere it could be an entrance.
Mm. I mean, entrance for carts.
Alright.
There'd be a sign up just saying markets this way.
There would be.
Okay, so my searching would come to an end near where the markets would be.
Mm-hmm.
How many vendors or people would there be selling stuff here?
Give me one sec.
Like?
Yeah. I have them on another screen because I was planning to swap back and forth.
That was a terrible idea.
Hey, that was before I gave up on the idea.
Yeah, you should have just done the houses that you with roofs that you can just turn invisible.
I tried. It needs a lot of setup, so I gave up.
Fair.
But now, because everyone can use actual fog vision, I can just have it turned on, so you can just not look through walls.
But what if we can look through walls?
Not too bad.
Well, we have the X-ray ring.
Would it be safe to assume that the sort of the front part of the mark would be over here?
Kind of. It would be like you walk in anywhere kind of thing.
Okay, so I don't particularly want to be attempting to make a deal with people from behind their shop. Because that's going to be a little weird.
So over here is where they hold most of their equipment, and this is where they just put things out to show.
Okay. So I'll take a closer look, and what would be on the first bench?
This one would be more for like bags of seed, farming, slash a little bit of gathering stuff. He spins so fast.
Okay, and what would be on the bench beneath this?
That would be more hunting gear. A lot of more hunting gear. Like bear traps, and a few other things. Just so you know, this person here looks like they're somewhat of a blacksmith apprentice.
Yeah, if they look at me, I'll sort of nod in their direction.
They would nod back.
How much for your hunting traps?
I think the sir said, well, how many hunting traps are you after? Usually we only we sell them for only a few, I think a couple of gold. Yeah, like 3-4 gold.
Well, would they be reusable? Do they require fixing after they've been used?
Let me just double check this. It should be, you can reuse them. Yep, you can reuse them.
Yeah, in that case, I'm interested in 2 hunting traps.
Because you're buying multiple of them, they will sell it for you to 5 gold. Let me do this as well.
Yeah, I don't know how to set up the trading thing that you normally do, man.
I do it for NPCs.
A shop person lady.
Yes.
So, how much gold again?
5 gold for both.
I didn't think I had that much gold.
I know, you have more gold than you could ever imagine.
He's rich.
No, it says I have 100 gold pieces, but I didn't think I had 100 gold pieces. Oh, well.
Well, you do now.
Yeah, that would be added to your inventory.
And I sort of tuck them away in my bag.
Is there anything else I could help you with?
Been meaning to find something to hold scraps of paper to write on. I'm not sure if you'd have access to anything like a scroll case, would you? It's just something to keep them protected.
She thinks for a moment and rustles through her little things. And she says, I can scrounge one up if you give me just a couple of minutes.
By all means, take all the time you need.
She said it'll only cost you 1 gold.
I'm fine with that.
I've done the wrong person. Hold on. I did chat, not Nez.
You're trying to trade chat?
Yep.
Now, where have been? Oh, that has another special inventory slot.
Yep.
Let me open my bag. I'll drag the traps in there. And I'll say, okay, have a pleasant day.
You as well.
I'll sort of give her a bit of a bow. And then is when I'd be looking for the adventuring party that I was with earlier.
Give me one sec.
I think that's just a click of the dice there.
Yep.
Wisdom roll.
Oh, if you just click for dice in the actual thing.
I did click the dice and it's popped up a thing. Oh, it would modify a wisdom.
Yeah, it presets up.
Man, that was so close to a higher number.
Okay. So you won't find them straight away, but if you look around town for probably about 10-ish or so minutes, you probably should run into them again.
Yeah, I'd expect it to take like 5 to 10 minutes, so yes, I will spend the next 10 minutes I guess, actively looking for them.
Expects very well. Immediately runs into them.
It's like, and 10 minutes have passed. Like, well, that was quick.
I know, right? Kaeshron, if you're walking out and actively looking around, you would probably see a familiar face in the market-ish area.
That's like, void him! Nah. Nah, I'll probably go and, like, walk up.
It'll be midway buying sex B cases.
It's like, huh, I wonder where that party is. Us behind the tree.
Before we move on, Nash, do you want me to lock your character's rotation?
Yeah, probably should. I don't know why it keeps doing that. Like, I'm not actually rotating it.
Because you're using two fingers.
Ah.
Hold on, don't move. Give me a sec.
Thank you, Chaos, for the drink.
Rotation update token.
Chaos, why have you lost it?
You say that. Your rotation is now locked, Sage.
Thank you.
Has Chaos ever had it to begin with?
Well, he's exactly. He's doing an X marks the spot. He's saying he found buried treasure.
No. I mean, do we believe him? No, absolutely not.
Well, his buried treasure is those worms he's so eager to get.
Exactly. I want Tiger to have more friends.
Since when do you care about friends?
I don't, but Tiger wants some. And I don't,
yeah, the bad, and you shouldn't be caring about that. You don't care about anything or anyone.
I care about Tiger and Vanessa.
Do we believe him?
Give me one second.
Have a choice about caring about Vanessa, but I do care about Tiger.
Hold on.
I mean, Tiger just wants a pet chicken.
Tiger would get eaten by said chicken.
So you feel a chill down your spine, as if you're being watched, Chaos, as you say you care about Vanessa.
Okay.
Like, ooh, I take that back.
You better not be lying.
Alright. So, continuing on.
Alright.
Okay.
Hey there, stranger.
Oh, it's nice seeing you again.
I mean, I would say it'd be nice seeing you, but again...
There's going to be so many blind jokes.
I know, right?
I almost didn't see it coming. I almost didn't see it coming.
Oh, I almost didn't see you coming and coming over to me. Puts out foot.
Yeah, you're all the way over here. Like,
it's like, why do I feel like someone just said a pun on the wind?
I'm just going to head up here.
So, well, what's your plan now?
Well, I've got two things that I've been tasked with doing. One of them is making sure someone gets to their destination safely, and the other one, surprisingly enough, is actually a tag along with you guys, because... Well, I'll keep it brief and say to keep an eye on things, and I can go into more detail in not so public of a place.
That's fair. Don't like it when there's so many eyes on me. Granted, I don't have any myself.
But you do have eyes, just hidden.
Puns.
I am going full Brook this session. Anyway.
So what would be your plans after, I suppose, yous are done in the town?
Well, we were kind of hoping of moving on to another place. But honestly, we don't know where to go next. So, since you have a heading, we'll probably just follow you.
Oh, fair enough. As the adventure types, there's probably no shortage of work you need to do.
Yeah, that's true.
Did you forget you've also been tasked to informing the Lord?
Oh, yeah, that's also true. But we have a few ways of getting up there.
God, hey, who are you talking to? Oh, it's you again.
I'll sort of give you a salute as you talk to me, I suppose.
Yeah, no need to salute. Seriously.
I'd rather be seen as formal when I'm out in public, thank you.
Yeah, that's why I stayed away from the law. I don't like that formal stuff. Seriously, you guys are a bunch of stiffs.
Yeah, I mean, I can see where you're coming from. It's not the life for everyone.
Yeah, what are you two schmucks talking about?
Where we're heading to next.
That's a good idea. We should get Chaos as well. Wherever the hell he went off to.
Chaos will follow along to wherever we decide to go.
I bet if you whistle and say Chaos, he'll come running.
Don't you mean say his name three times?
Try it, I dare you.
But it's so peaceful without him.
True. Anyway, so where are you going to be taking this escort to?
Oh, Nate, right, tasking my memory. I think they were also heading to the capital, if my memory serves me, right, DM?
Yes, they're heading to the city, like the capital city of this domain, then they're heading to the capital of the country.
Yeah, then I'll say that their first step would be near the capital city.
King's Watch, and then Ostend?
I mean, well, yes. I wouldn't reference names, because I myself don't know them, but...
We have
I'll say in that general area.
DM, am I right in that?
Yes, you would have... you do have access to a map, and Nez, your character would probably be a bit more aware of the names of places, and would have actually easier access to military-grade maps than other players.
Yes, the reason why I'm trying to avoid using names is because I don't particularly know the group too well.
Fair enough.
Yeah, that's
As stated before, in a public place where people can eavesdrop.
Yes.
Okay. Then in that case, we have a few ways of getting up there.
Man. Oh. You said you're heading to Salt Mill last time?
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
if you're heading the other direction, I'm going to quickly make a map.
Well, now I kind of want to suggest going there just to make you do more work, but no, going to a basalt mill is probably the better course of action. It's more direct.
Yeah.
Well, in a case, do you happen to be after any suppliers here?
Probably apart from food for the travel, I'm pretty much set.
And you, Nash, or Mushu?
Still got some little bits and bobs there, but I'll ask.
I can eat off wild plants and weeds.
And probably anything else that we hunt.
Yeah.
Well, I can't imagine weeds would taste too good, but I suppose I've heard of stranger diets.
Yeah. How are you living, kid? Seriously, how are you living like that?
With great difficulty. As I watch this map come around us.
I know, right? Just so you're aware, Mushi would actually also be able to tell which plants are more likely to be poisoned than other plants.
I mean, so there's a usefulness to that madness.
Yes. I'm letting you know in case that ever comes up in conversation.
Crowd of me.
Hey, look who showed up.
Yo. I thought we were heading to the magic person. Got lost.
How did you get lost? We've been around this town 100 times. Not to mention it's a small town, so how could you get lost?
I got lost on the road of life. That's why I'm dead.
Well, we're gonna be dead if you're gonna keep dilly-dallying around.
So you'll become one of my brethren?
Weird choice of words.
And to answer your question, I'd rather be tormented, tortured a zillion times over than be your brethren.
You know what? That's fair. You can be my scarf instead.
Nope, my body is going straight for the under.
With how much disdain you seem to have for each other, sort of wondering how it is that you're traveling together, but...
Circumstances, mostly.
It's yeah, a
I'm pretty sure that wouldn't be my place
it's to love. It's a love-hate relationship.
Yeah, mostly no, hating you.
It's hate, man.
I love tormenting him and he just hates me. Love-hate relationship.
Yeah, I honestly wish you were dead, though, but I'm stuck with you, so...
Anyway, the blacksmith mentioned something about a person that is knowledgeable in magic and may have some magic items. So...
Mm. We should probably pop there first before we head off.
Yeah, that'll probably be good.
Mm. Yeah, well, we do somewhat lack magic, so...
Is it possible to exchange part of my class levels for a different class I'm already multiclassing in?
Not at this current time.
Yeah, okay. I mean, I would say that'd be part of it, like a downtime activity.
Yeah. Why are you making a big, squiggly, squarey mess?
Because he's bored.
And I'm not really allowed to wander off anymore, so I just settle with doing it in one spot.
You just climb all over the tables and desks of tradespeople.
I've put a border around this map. You can go all over now.
No, it's, remember how I kept wandering off in the dungeon nearly dying or dying?
Yeah, but that's in a dungeon. That's in a town where you're safe. I don't mind it.
Yeah, I just don't want to get into bad habits again. So, just stick in the same area as you guys.
But I mean, if you're planning on going to a magic
shop... It didn't work!
I suppose I can take a little look to see what they have, see if I can potentially get anything with a benefit to me.
Alright then. DM, take us to the magic shop, please.
Take us away.
Take us.
You've arrived at a magic shop.
Oh, it's right there.
It's literally right here.
I've been waiting.
It's too close. It's too convenient.
That's way too
it
convenient.
It just appears out of nowhere whenever we need it.
Why do you guys need... get pulled in by the DM?
Because we're
like, they're not skilled.
I mean, to be fair, it looked like a small store, so I'd wait my turn for everyone else to go in first.
Mm. Well,
this just indicates to me that you're talking to this person.
Okay.
Mushu's talking to them.
Knock on the door. Hello?
Oh.
Ding ding ding.
Hello there. How can I help you?
Told that you were good with identifying magic and may have some magical specialties here.
Oh yes, I can definitely help you with that.
That sounded so wrong.
Why did you have to twist that?
I'm sorry, but it just did.
I'm trying to put on a female voice, leave me alone.
Can't you just get a voice modulator for that?
Yeah. I can, but I don't want to boot it up every single time.
Now you know I've given up doing voices.
I know, right? I'm getting there as well. I try with every character, though.
I always love doing voice acting. It's always great.
Yeah, I know. I try and make my voice somewhat softer when I do female characters so you can tell the gender at the very least.
Yeah, I've always wanted to learn how to voice act and mimic voices, simply to mess with people.
Oh, God.
I mean,
how can I help you?
I go in and, like, pull out another one, the crystal from before, and it's like, can you help by directly identifying how powerful this is?
She takes the crystal from your hand, if you offer it to her.
Yep.
And it looks as if her eyes glow. She then hands it back to you and says, it can be used for small-scale ritual spells,
But with the amount of material that you'd make from it to, you know, craft a magic spell, would be very insufficient. If you had maybe like 9-10 more crystals, you'd be able to make almost a medium to small to medium sized magic circle.
Okay, fair enough. Can it like be used for enchanting, or do I need more of that?
It would probably be better if you did get more, just because it hasn't gone through purification ritual yet.
Right, I will lose more mass but that way. Anyway. Do you guys have questions?
Yes, I have a steel mirror I found in a cultist hideout. It was very well hidden, I almost didn't spot it. So I'm wondering if there was anything special about it.
Or do you hold it out to her?
Yes.
Her eyes would then glow again and go, oh, this seems to be somewhat of maybe an old artifact that has lost its properties.
Do you know a way for me to recharge it in a way to make it gain back?
I wouldn't know how to, but maybe my master who taught me magic would be able to guide you in the correct way.
Let me guess, they're in the city.
They're in the capital.
Oh, okay, a bit further away.
So, after she says that, she informs you that she is actually the disciple of one of the leading magicians of the entire country.
Melon?
No. What did we name her? Give me a sec.
Gandalf.
That's not Gandalf. Anyway, so she is referring to the witch that Zeph told you about.
Okay.
From your understanding, you'd probably guess that. Also, Tobias, the god above all, is still watching over you.
The goddess, you said?
No, that one's in chat. Tobias is watching over you. You get hungry.
Such a shame he's not here to tell him that himself.
I know, right?
He probably is. He's just screaming from the other side.
Why in hell?
Hold on.
I have a brilliant idea.
What?
I go up to the magic woman and say, do you know of a way I can breed magic worms?
Oh, what God. The fuck?
I have never in my 150 years of life heard such a question.
Now, trust us, he's a weird one.
I mean, does that mean it's a good question or a bad question?
It is a question I do not have an answer to.
I guess to the tiger as he pokes himself out of my cheek. See, I want to give this guy a family, but I also want him to be useful. So...
I will mention
this to you now. If you want to breed that worm, it is way above my pay grade.
How in the world do worms breed?
With other worms. When a male worm and a female worm love each other very much.
But worms don't have genders. They're genderless.
But they can identify if they're smart enough.
Hey, this is fantasy world. Maybe it's a celestial worm. You don't know.
Let's not turn this into a national geographic.
And if it's apparently above her pay grade, then is Tiger actually secretly powerful? Is that why I can't find another one?
Oh, great!
I will not answer that question.
he doesn't want to answer it.
Oh my god, Tiger is actually special. That's why his reaction will affect.
He's already eaten a worm. It's in his cheek.
It's in my body, and you can go up and down as it pleases.
Yes, I know.
So could the worm be the MVP of the whole campaign?
You can take my again, life. Not confirm or deny. So it could be the final boss, will you know?
I know, it's going to be a Grunglefuck.
No, fuck. Listen to this. We're fighting the final boss. I'm the only one left. I have 1 HP, and if I take one more damage, I'll go on death saving throws.
The worm saves us.
Yeah, the worm gets in the way and takes that damage while I'm perfectly fine, launch an attack and win.
You eat the worm and it gives you a healing like it would a good berry, so someone's no longer unconscious.
We are not bringing the good berries worm with bandit. The worm.
No, the worm bandit. I'm the worm bandit.
Sorry, that doesn't have a good impact as the good berry bandit. It doesn't have a good impact.
No. I'll figure something out. But first, I need more worms.
Okay.
Go in a garden, you'll find some.
Anything else?
Any sort of magic items are you able to sell us?
Magic items? I have a couple that I could probably part with.
Probably.
For the right price.
For the right price, of course.
What types of magical equipment would we be looking for? Looking at weapons, armor, rings, necklaces, gloves, boots.
I have a couple of wands and a couple of scrolls, as well as a couple of magical potions. Well, I have more potions than anything else.
All of them sound fascinating.
Yeah, but can you afford it? That's the question.
Well, tell me what you have, and then I'll be able to find out.
Yeah, give us a list of what you have and their prices.
I have healing potions.
Always.
Or potion of healing, I should say. That is 50 gold!
Alright, Chaos, you're up.
I got...
Not buying any.
Because you got the most money out of all of us, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, he does.
Oh my god, why is that potion so expensive? No.
I don't need any potions, I have some. I got them for free.
Oh no, you have to buy them for the rest of us.
Yeah, no. Unless you're gonna pay me back somehow.
I'll pay you back by letting you have my tail when I die.
Not worth it.
What do you mean not worth it? You can turn that into a scarf. That's all you wanted.
Yeah, but it's his tail, so it's not even worth a copper.
Okay, you get to do whatever you want to my corpse. Bury it, dismember it, or insert me into some jewelry. I don't care.
That is not a wise choice of words.
Yeah, I'm a cleric, you see? I could reanimate you.
And I have, yeah, so she has some healing potions, which, for good ones, can set you back, well, for cheapest ones, they can set you back almost 50 gold. She has a potion, I can't bloody say what it is for, but it is for against poison, antidote, that's it, antitoxin, even more correct. And, as in scrolls, she has 4 scrolls for cantrip spells.
Okay. Wait, did you say any rings?
No, I did say wands.
Oh, rons. Then why was I thinking rings?
Wait, did you just say rons? Hello and welcome to Ron's Wands.
Would this be Ron Weasley?
Nah, it'll be Fred Weasley.
But the wand that she has, which is a wand of lightning bolts, is not really in the best condition, so it can only be used 2 times.
Does it recharge? Or 2 times and that's it?
2 times, that's it.
Ugh.
But she's willing to give you a discount on that one.
I'd say it's better we maybe get our magic supplies at a bigger town, or I don't know, that's just my opinion.
Again, she doesn't specify in magic items. She does predictions.
Well,
predictions, you say? Like, what type
like of weather predictions? Predictions on your fortune.
Mm. Can she predict how long it's going to take for me to kill Chaos?
He's already dead, she says.
Oh no, like, how much longer it is until I'm actually going to lose it at him?
She can't determine that, because I can't determine that.
She can't foresee my actions. I am me and me alone.
Well, that's my actions, though, losing it at you.
Yeah, but it'll be my actions that set you off.
And if you need any other types of potions, if you have the ingredients, she can make them.
I have some human hearts. Are those useful?
She looks at you in bewilderment. She says she's not a necromancer.
But they could be used for hearts. I know that much. I mean, they could be used for potions.
She can't do anything with them.
Oh. What about these horse skulls?
These what? Hold on.
She can turn them into cups. That's it.
What about these bagpipes?
They're bagpipes.
Damn. What about Tiger?
Tiger, bites you. And,
Tiger. I'm only joking.
I want to know how a worm bites.
No, you don't.
Aren't their mouths very similar to, like, the sandworms from Doom?
I don't know Doom, so I can't really say I know what
it
that
is.
It is
full of razor sharp teeth.
I know something similar, but I don't know. I can't think of it off the top of my head.
Oh, she also remembers she has a wand of magic detection. Again, however, that only has 3 charges. Yeah, it can also recharge.
Oh,
that one is probably out of your payment.
How much is it?
How
cost?
Much?
15.
15
gold?
1,000.
Oh.
15,000 what?
Gold pieces.
Okay.
That is expensive.
I mean,
sorry, 1,500.
You could say 15,000 copper. It's like, I think I probably could if it's copper.
True.
So, 1,500 gold pieces.
1,500 gold pieces.
Yeah, no.
Hey, this is before haggling, don't forget. You can, if you want to haggle, you can.
At best, I have about 200.
At best, I have a bit over 400, maybe just a little under 500.
Yeah, we won't be able to get it. Anyway.
Keep in mind, because you guys only have, two spellcasters. I am planning to throw stuff at you in dungeons and that.
Yeah,
that's equipment.
If I can switch around one of my, two of my monk levels into cleric, then that'll be better, but...
Yeah, how do you deal with using spells from wands or scrolls? For instance, like a spellcaster check. I don't think UMD is a check in this anymore.
So let me use the wand of magic detection as an example. It has 3 charges. You can use one of them to cast detect magic. It just casts it. It doesn't. You don't get
You don't need to do a check. Checks are for spell scrolls.
Yeah, like say for instance, I wanted to buy spell scrolls of say cure wounds, cure wounds, it's not cure light wounds, or a wand of it.
So you'd be able to buy that. However, because you're also proficient in that spell, since it's a part of your, I guess, class, if I remember correctly, I would let you also add the bonus to it, which would be like your, I think, spell modifier.
Yes, but the main reason to think to get like a wand to say, like, for instance, all of us goes down, there's one person left standing, we would have a wand to be able to at least bring other people up.
I don't think you can change spell scrolls into wands, which is sad.
Yeah, I don't think those types of wands I'm thinking of exist in 5e, unfortunately.
I would say, if you're thinking of changing a spell, like a scroll into a wand, you could probably do it through a high ranking, like I'd probably let happen if you want to, if you ever meet an NPC which is specializes in magic and is skilled enough, I may allow it then. However, I don't believe there is a mechanic in normal 5e.
Yeah, in 5e, no. If you've played the older versions, it's like, say, for instance, a Wand of Cure Light Wounds would have 50 charges on it, but you'd need to use a Use Magical Device check in order to actually physically use it, unless you can already cast the spell. But in any case, I will pick up a few of the Potions of Healing, because, worst case, it's not going to be a bad idea to have some of them.
How many are you looking for?
How many are there?
She can give you 5 at the moment, and she'll even give you a deal.
Okay, what sort of a deal for the 5?
Buy 3, get 2.
I'm fine with that, that's 150 gold.
She'll let you take her for 125.
That should be the correct currency.
Mm-hmm. Also, and before I am... go, she's also going to give you another thing. She's going to give you a sprinkler. As a gift. Because she doesn't get many customers.
Well, I will thank her for the trinket as well. And I'll give it a small look over before putting it away into my packs.
All good. It's like a little, lucky rabbit's foot.
A lucky worm. Does that count?
Okay, well, I'll sort of hold it in my hands. As stated, I'll give it a bit of a look, and then I'll put it away into my backpack.
Very well. Does anyone else want to inquire about anything?
I'm good.
I'm good.
No, I'm good.
And now I'm going to turn around to the rest of the group and say, does everyone have at least a potion of healing?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty sure.
Hey, pretty sure or check.
Okay, fine, I'll check.
Because if you don't have one, I would be handing one of these to you as well.
You have them.
Potion of Greater Healing.
Okay, I mean, that's better than the ones I have, but it's a way to bring someone up if they're unconscious.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Right then, shall we hit it off?
I guess so.
Yeah, we should.
Alright, in that case, I will remind the group that the Adventurers Guild said they will give them a car if they can wait until the next day. So if there's nothing else in town that you want to do, we can time skip to them.
Okay.
Now that we're taking a break, would I be able to transfer Monk class to Cleric? Is that possible?
I'm going to say it will require more than one break to do so.
Okay.
Yeah, I think I'd probably put it at like a week myself.
Yeah.
Well, that's fine. I'll get started on that then, if that's okay.
Very well. I'll allow you to do that in long rest. I won't make it affect you, as you're just practicing.
Yeah.
Or praying.
Yeah, that too.
Okay.
Yep.
You go and kneel down and it's like, hey, God, I think I messed up with my leveling. Can you help me?
If it was an entire different class, I would say no, but if it's one that you already have, then yeah.
Yeah.
In that case, I'm gonna throw that down. He's gonna come here.
We take a long rest?
I am doing that now. Give me
That's
one sec.
That's a big car.
Yes, it's the big car. I clicked wrong button, hold on.
Are we supposed to hit that? She said wrong button.
Yeah, you can hit it. It'll just prompt you again. So you should all have your hit dice back, if I remember correctly.
Yes.
And all your day spells should be now done.
Yep.
And I will also move group here. Since I'm gathering you guys are coming out again.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Arkadot, she can be hidden again. You two can be hidden again. I need to do this thing.
Yes, assuming that we would have sort of sat down and had some type of a meal, at that point is where we would have brought up other things as well.
If you want to do that now, while I do the last few chain things I need to add to your card, you can.
Okay.
I wonder if I go out there and eat more dirt, would I find another worm?
Doubtful.
I'm going to try.
Alright, so chaos has already gone off the table. So I'll sort of say in a bit of a quieter voice, and I say, well, the reason why I was asked to keep an eye on you is because I've been told that the summoning circle that you disrupted may have an adverse impact on us. And that includes myself.
Ah.
How so?
I wasn't told how so. I was just told to keep an eye on it.
Does this mean...
Hey, something else to worry about.
Maybe this will be how a tiger becomes magical.
Gonna, like,
you're not even here, so I can't even respond to that.
I am there. I'm with you.
You said you went out to go look for dirt.
But literally outside. I can just crouch down and rummage through the dirt where I'm standing.
As I said, I'd say this when we're around a table, like presumably over a meal or a drink.
Then why are we outside?
Because I just put you there. He's doing a recap while you're long resting.
Yeah, so rather than time skip everything, I'm getting this out now while preparations being made for us to move onwards.
Sorry, I was so confused a bit because we were outside. That just boggled my mind for a moment.
Anything boggles your mind?
Well, I mean, there could be a table out the front.
True.
There could be.
Doesn't take much to boggle my three brain cells.
I figured I'd let you know this now before you found it out from someone else.
Well, who else would we found it from? Who else would have told us? We're just a bunch of adventurers. No one gives a crap about us.
Considering that I've been tasked as one of my missions, it could have come up in conversation from any other guard.
True.
And I'd rather be honest that you find this out from me than someone else.
Smart.
And that way, if you feel anything, I guess, different. Maybe you feel different types of magic, or there's charge in the air, or something unusual. This way you also know this to look out for things.
Fair.
Just ignore chaos, though. I think if he were cursed, he'd be happy with it.
Although I suppose in your case, Ulrich, I'd have to say, keep a feel out for things.
Hey, love it. Yeah, I'll keep my eyes open, so to say.
You and your blind jokes.
Yeah. Anyway, I see a cart.
You should now see carts near your player token.
The only one I can see is like a big, was it like a 5x4 token?
In like where you have your character sheet, that section in actors.
Yes.
That there is your group stuff.
Oh.
So your group, your current group members, plus NPCs, your food, any cargo you want, any passengers you get, and if you want to give money as like a collective, so like, oh yeah, we need to buy extra supplies. You add it to the currency of the card.
How do we add it?
You tell me, and you just take it out of your character sheet and I just put it in.
It'll be funny if we go up to like crew and cargo and see that there's a 2 next to one of us. It's like
400 and what?
467 copper coins.
Right, no.
I don't know why you're putting copper coins into it.
Because I want to keep the rest.
Also, the feed is for the horses that would probably pull your cart. That are pulling your cart.
Yeah, that's fair.
I will manage horses so you don't have to worry about them.
Don't worry. One day when Tiger's big enough, he can pull the cart.
Just wondering, is someone going to sleep in the cart? Because it says 2-person tent and there's 5 of us.
I have 5.
There's 5 2-person tents in there.
So each of us gets a very big tent.
If you gain an NPC, or like, if you want to bunker up, it's there. Hold on.
Okay.
Now, is that just what's on us, or is that what's in the cart?
That's what's in the cart. Cargo's like permanent cart.
Is this permanently our cart, or is this just on loan?
It has been given to you.
Nice. Dibs as a driving. Type of payment.
Maybe we can get some unicorns.
As you approach Catron, the guild member would come to you and say, "Ah, there you are. I got the cart just as we promised."
Beautiful, thank you.
He gestures to the 2 horses as well. Since you're active adventurers, we got some strong horses that can also take a bit of a beating pulling it for you.
Oh, I see that you got us Mustangs.
Nothing but the best.
We'll see.
I go up into the driver's seat.
I'm hopping in the back. Let me just go around to the back.
Also, Nez, as you're walking down, you'd see the command of a local area. She would just sit for you to come and talk to her.
Yeah, then I will call out to the rest of people and say, "I'll only be a moment," and then I'll start walking down this way.
She is going to hand you a letter and says, "If you get to the capital of the domain, hand this to the guards at the Lord's Manor."
Can I assume I'm not to open it?
Yes. Keep it tightly sealed and on your person.
I will do so.
Thank you. She thanks you, and she wishes you good luck.
Yeah,
and may the gods smile upon you.
So I will give her a salute, and then I will start moving back to the group.
Okey-doke.
I don't know if there's actual slots on the cart or whatnot.
You just jump on the cart's image, and I just select and drag.
Yeah, well, I guess there. Well, I can see myself, but no one else.
I can see myself above the image.
I can see myself in a corner of a Catron.
Ah.
Yeah. So it's whatever token you touch last is on
not
top.
Not letting me go towards the cart.
What do you mean?
You said the thing.
Yeah, due to the square I did, it won't let me go across now because it needs to finish that. It needs to finish that before I can move anywhere.
It seems like I have suffered consequences of my own actions.
There we go, he's finished.
Yeah. Well, if it isn't the actions of my consequences.
Always fun to deal with those.
Oh no, even better. Well, 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 if it isn't, the my consequences now have actions against me.
I'm gonna blame my left brain cell for that. My right one's innocent. The middle one just doesn't care.
What do you mean your middle one?
You have three brains.
The one that's actually... Yes, one on the left half of my brain, one on the right, and one that acts as a bridge between the two.
The middle decided to take the day off.
No, the middle one's the only actual smart one, but due to that, it has to balance the other two. If it doesn't, then chaos.
So it's taking a day off is what I'm hearing.
No, it's just a bit overworked right now. It's currently fainted.
It reminds me of that age-old insult. You have two brain cells and they're fighting for third place.
Not wrong.
So what happens now? Do you move the carriage DM or do we switch to another map?
So it depends. Are you leaving?
I'm ready whenever you guys are.
Same.
Yeah.
Unless you have emergency supplies, I'm ready to start heading off as well.
Okay. The horses are pretty easy to control since they're tamed and taught. They've been taught how to behave. So I won't get you to do an animal handling check. Cart would begin to make its way up and out of Samhill.
Now, where are we going to this time?
Hell. We need to go and find my wife.
Oh. Well, this does look like hell.
The title screen. I knew it.
We've broken the fourth wall.
Our characters are going to leave the game and come to the real world.
Well, they have to break the fifth wall to do that.
They have to break the virtual wall.
That's not as hard as what you think. That's nice and zoomed out.
Mine's still loading.
Lovely area around here.
It won't let me go up to the top of the screen. It keeps dragging me back to the cart.
That's all you deserve to be here.
So you come to a crossroad.
I think it's a fork, not a crossroad.
Well, yeah, it's technically a crossroad, but there's a tree in the middle of it.
Ah. No, it's still a fork.
Could you actually roll perception for me? Yurik?
All of us?
Oh, no, just Yurik. You guys are in the car.
Like, there's a fork in the road. Dinner's up, Mushu.
Shit.
Oh, sugar honey iced tea!
Which direction? So, you have bath salt milk this way, and you have Arcane Lane this way.
So, yeah, we'll be heading to Basel, so we'll be heading up this way.
But as you go past the tree line, you notice something.
Ah.
Hey, what's going on at the front there?
I have no clue. Who was the bright idea to let the blind person drive?
I know, right?
Fine.
I mean, you jumped at the chance to do it.
And those have been doing so well.
Okay, fine. Yeah. Well, what did you hear there?
Your voice.
Well, shut up.
With this conversation, that would also take notice of you.
Can I roll stealth?
I mean, we're in the cart, so they might not be able to actually see us right now.
Yeah, they won't be able to see those in the cart. They see a cart, a blind man driving.
Rolling stealth.
Sure, you can roll stealth.
Immediately roll stealth.
Not bad, not bad. Not good, mm-hmm, but...
Mm-hmm. Believe me, you don't want me to roll stealth.
Do it.
Roll if you want.
No.
Yes.
Stealth is not my strong suit, and I'd rather not have it fail.
So,
how much...
What is exactly I see?
Negative with disadvantage.
You see what seems to be a band attack, and what seems to be some type of knight in whitish armor, laying dead, or about to die, on the road, and a destroyed cart.
Okay. Since this is the way that I need to go, I'll probably, like, slow down the car and it's like, hey, is this, the way to Basalt Mill?
Boy. It is. But I think you've picked the wrong day to leave. Now that you've seen this, we can't really let you go now. Well, I guess you're blind?
Yep, as I put my hand in front of my face doesn't change.
And she's like, and what did I supposedly see?
What did I supposedly see?
Start like doing the inconspicuous whistle.
Do we have to, you know, kill him? As they take a side glance at each other, thinking, what the hell are they meant to do now?
The bosses would have said, make sure no one sees what you do, and...
Yeah.
They didn't! They didn't say anything about blind men driving the carriage.
The blind men!
Me doing the bit, Neza, something really cool.
What up?
I need your roll perception.
Oh, that's
pretty.
Very nice.
So I'm going to tell you this, Neza. You immediately recognize the knights that are laying on the ground are Templar knights.
Well, shit.
I will leave it at that.
So I'm sure
also, you see somewhat... of a trail leading off into the bushes behind them.
I'm assuming with that, there's like a window or something in the cart we can see out of.
You'd be able to glance through the gaps in like the canopy, I think it's called.
Canopy carriage, so yeah.
Yeah, so you'd be able to glance through like the gaps leading out, or like just between the gap between the chair and where the chair is connected to, like, the driver's chair. And there's probably a couple of holes in the canopy here and there.
Alright, so what's the call?
I mean, I'm absolutely going to point out, like, whisper that these people are, you know, Templar Knights. And I'll sort of point them out to everyone else that's currently in the car.
What are the Templar Knights again?
The people that are meant to be protecting someone.
No, like, I know that, but what are Templar
Knights? They are holy knights. Knights that serve the Grand Church.
Ah, that does make sense. Kind of in the
Yes,
name.
The Grand Church is the church that manages and runs like pretty much all churches in this world. Since they believe pretty much in, like, the gods themselves. They're also... The Pope that runs the Grand Church is also, you could consider, the King of the Holy Kingdom. Lord Rob.
Alright. So do we want to step in, or do we want to just leave them be?
Well, I don't particularly want to leave them be, but if everyone else is, I guess I can begrudgingly do so.
No. Let's protect the... Let's save them. Let's stop them.
I kind of, like, whisper back. It's like, hey, I got an idea. So my plan is to like make my way past them, and as I do so, the rest of the guys jump out the back of the carriage and attack them.
Yes, I love it.
So you want to surprise attack him?
Oh, obviously.
Hmm.
So does that mean you're moving the cart?
I kind of like turn to them. It's like, so am I okay to pass through?
I guess. But they're going to keep a sharp, full eye on you and the carriage.
Okay. It's like, oh, well, thank you very much. As I go in and just mosey on past them with the carriage.
Okay, I'm going to just move you through the bush line.
Yeah.
Because otherwise it's
going
to be
a If we're going past them here, I'll jump out when side opposite them into the trees to hide.
You may jump out whenever you want. Keep in mind, you're the only one self.
Yeah, that's why I'm jumping out here.
Apparently, no, you're not. You're coming with us.
Okay, you jump out?
Yep.
Yep. I'm running out of room. Anyone else jumping out?
We just leave Chaos behind.
Run away!
Bye, Chaos!
Yeah, I'm gonna leave the cart there. You can do as you wish from here.
Yes,
so you jump out.
Yes, in that case, I would jump out there as well. However, I do need to quickly want to go to the toilet before battle starts.
Sure thing. Anyone else wants to go to the toilet since I am technically running an ad break right now?
Yeah, I'll hop out too. And yes, I will. And I'll need to take a quick break too.
Well, I'm going to get the encounter thing ready. I'm also going to hide the carriage, just so you can, just so I can easily see your tokens.
Okay,
fair.
I can still see the carriage on my screen, but it just gets it rid of for like chat and you guys, so you don't have to worry about it being in your view.
Okay.
Yeah, I did not expect having the blind man pull the carriage to be the optimal way to get past this.
I know, I completely forgot about it too.
Now on, that's how we should always have the carriage go, the blind man driving it.
God damn it. I'm actually going to also change the cart from, so you can actually just move it yourselves.
Will all of us have control of it, or only the person driving?
There.
I'm going to say the only the person driving.
Okay.
But you can also take stuff from the cart, put stuff in it yourself now.
I have returned.
Ooh, I didn't know I could do that.
Oh, did somebody find something else?
I can give inspiration to the cart.
So, the cart is sentient.
I am going to feed the animals real quickly. I'll be right back.
Oh, good. I guess I should also. What's that?
No, I'm back in the car. It's gone.
Yeah, so I've just hidden it so it's easier for token control, so you don't have to worry about it.
Yeah, how did I pull this tracker out again? There it is. Yeah, can I assume that I don't get any type of,
not any capsules.
Just, yeah, I mean, I'm assuming so, because I explicitly stated no, I'm not stealthing, but it doesn't hurt to ask.
The only person that actually end up rolling stealth is Chaos, so only he gets surprised to take a round.
Aren't I special? Well,
I suppose on that note, if, do you do stealth as, like, a group check or individual checks?
Situation rise, I usually calculate on situation wise. However, from what we've been doing so far, it is individual.
Okay, because one of the main reasons why I didn't run a roll stealth is because, well, disadvantage -1. We're gonna get found if I do that.
Yeah, the only only time I really do like collectively is when it's like pretty much every single person, but maybe one person didn't succeed. It's like, I might as well just give it to everyone.
At that point, can I act as a distraction to give everyone else advantage?
You can.
That's probably the better way to do it.
Since I'd probably get advantage because of it anyway, because, oh, you sold them, because that's a condition. It would be, they'd probably get like +3 to their roll. Alright, look at these boys. No, I'm not sure. Where are these boys?
Hey, you want us to roll initiative?
Yes, please.
Come on. Oh shit.
Where's my character there?
Here are the knights, by the way.
Oh, very nice.
Wonder if I can loot their armor.
Don't you dare.
Yeah, just so you know, you'd be probably punished. And no one would buy it from you.
It says I'm gonna sell it.
No, didn't you?
You want a shrink object and give it to the worm?
Yeah,
what do you mean?
No, once I get enough of tigers, once Tiger's family's big enough, they can just pile themselves together to wear the suit. Just
you
one
mean
giant
to tell me
man.
You want to make a swarm?
A swarm of worms.
Yeah, swarm into an armor set to make it look like an animated armor.
Yeah, it's just like you get lots of mini robots to combine together to make one giant one.
Isn't that literally what happened in Delicious in Dungeon?
I don't know what that is.
It's a new anime.
So, animated armor was actually made of clawfish or something like that. And the armor was actually a shell.
Nice.
It was like a hive of clawfish in like one being.
Okay.
Good anime. You should watch it.
I'm going to probably
take
Netflix. Million
I'll
words.
Put it on the watch list.
Anyway, can the last two people to roll initiative, then we shall do surprise around with Chaos, and then we will start initiative.
Okay. So, me first, you said?
It will be you first, because of surprise stack around.
Okay. I'm gonna head here. And then here.
Mm-hmm.
And detect this guy with a short sword.
Okay. Roll to hit.
Oh, that should have been advantage. Shit.
You hit anyway.
Oh, okay, doesn't matter then.
Yeah, but that could have been a crit on the advantage roll.
If you want to see if you get crit, you can re-roll it.
Nah, I'm fine with max damage.
Okay. combat begins. Rick, you're first.
How the heck am I first? Like, I'm
I don't know.
Let's,
a 20.
No, that's never what happens when it's initiative order for me. Alright, let's go. 5, 10, 15. Alright, I'm just going to come up here, attack this guy, and I'm going to use my short sword. Hold on. Alright, come on, something good, please. Damn!
That will be a hit.
And bang. Alright, and I think I've got another one on a sneak attack, yes?
No.
Ah. Oh yeah, that's right. And then
Infernal
let me just
Hydrate.
Alright, I think I'll just leave it at that then.
Okay.
So I end my turn.
Yep. Kedron.
Okay, I'm going to pull the horses to a stop.
Yep.
And then... hay fever. 5, 10... Then go... 5...
It's space.
Right, yeah, it's space. Be right here.
Mm-hmm.
Target this guy. Big and attack roll. 13 to hit.
That is a hit.
Beautiful. I do not get sneak attack damage off him.
Yes, you do.
Oh, yeah, because there's an ally within 5 feet, right?
I learned because, ha ha ha.
So 14 points of damage in total. Sorry, I stole your kill.
I was honestly just happy to actually get some damage and a hit in, so hey, tag team.
Yeah.
The exit to the cut is this way.
I don't know if I have to wait for my name to be called before doing anything.
No. As soon as it moves, that's people saying that's the end of their turn.
Okay. So how much movement to jump out of the cart?
I would say because someone's already opened the cart, you just walk out, drop.
Okay. That's 25 feet of movement. I can't do what I was going to do because that one is now
dead.
Gone. So, dead. I'm going to spawn a small skeletal hand next to the other bandit, and I'm going to attack it using Chill Touch.
Very well. That will be a hit.
Eight points of necrotic. And that is the end of my turn.
Chaos didn't even get another turn, or Mushi.
I had a turn, so I'm happy.
Well, you didn't get another turn, though, and Mushi.
I'm fine. I'm fine with having the one.
Well, Mushi's just in the cut, like, is it my turn?
Yeah, in that case, can I tell if the Templar Knight in front of me is alive?
He is at the point of no recovery, but he has enough strength to relay a message to you.
What do you mean a point of no recovery?
Can't I cast Cure Wounds on him?
I mean, I could bonus action Healing Word right now. What do you mean point of no recovery?
Yeah, we have healing.
I mean, he is only alive through sheer willpower.
Meaning that you can still recover.
He's meaning his heart has already stopped.
How does that work?
You have an undead in your group. Get over it.
Yeah, well, this guy is an undead, though.
To be fair, as a shadow sorcerer, my heart doesn't beat anyway.
To be fair, as a soldier of God, he is only alive because God has allowed it.
And no, to be fair, this just sounds like blah 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 because the DM can't think of an excuse.
If the first time I use healing word, it's going to...
If isn't working properly, then I can... Let him one of my five ones. I can just replace his heart with one of my five.
Fuck you lot.
You're trying to get out of this, but you can't.
I am trying... I only left him there as an unmarked as not dead yet because I need him to tell you about something. Beyond that, he is no use to me.
He
only lives because of plot. Leave it alone.
See, at that point, it might be better to just feel like he has a letter on him or something, rather than he himself needs to say something.
Fair. But he wouldn't really be able to write a letter as he's fighting.
Movie logic. We move to heal him. He says, wait, I need to pass on the message before you do anything. He tells us, then dies.
Sure, let's go with that. Jesus Christ. I couldn't make it a letter because he was literally just finished a battle before you showed up.
He writes it in
So what you're saying is, if I had jumped out the cart to begin with and then start action with bonus action healing word, he could have lived.
Yes.
Wow.
Can we reload our last save?
No.
Slash quick save?
Bitch, he tells you they've taken the scientist. Have fun.
Well, who's he told it to?
The one person that hears his dying breath.
Which one of us is that?
We're all equal distance away. We're all 10 feet.
Surprisingly, all you do. How about Mushi is? Mushi is the one that fucking hears him. How about that?
That's the first
fucking movie logic, bitch.
That's not movie logic, that's just continuity error.
Can you roll perception to hear it?
I'm just gonna say you hear it. Jesus Christ. Have you never seen a bloody, in a story, a written story, a character's like, oh yeah, let me heal you. There are warrior that would refuse it as they fought blindly and don't want to taint their honor. So they just want to pass on a message and pass along with their honor. That's it. That's all they want
to
do.
I could yell at people to heal them.
Yeah. And in this case, in the case of movies, they don't have healing potions, nor healing magic, nor it's not effective enough.
Have you not watched a fantasy movie, boy?
Or we could do this. Nez's healing word wasn't strong enough to save him, but he refused my healing because I'm undead.
I mean, you want another easy way to explain it? Necrotic damage. You can't heal it in the same turn of stealth.
True.
We're just trying to help.
Plot. Move on.
Yeah, I'm trying to give you two plausible ways of actually doing it.
Otherwise, there's just a continuity.
I had to rush make four bloody maps. I couldn't be bothered coming up with a proper excuse. No, move on.
Sorry, we can't
just
move
pick
on.
One
buddy.
Of the reasons that has been said. That is why he dies. Move on.
Alright guys, which scenario do we pick?
The necrotic damage, obviously, because that means one of them has a magical weapon.
Yes. I'm gonna loot this guy and these two daggers here.
I'll loot the one in front of me as well.
Okay, add two daggers to your inventory, Chaos.
Oh yay. Just two normal daggers?
Yes.
Oh.
It's just investigation, isn't it?
Yes.
Mine sucked.
Mine's not half bad.
Investigation.
Man, I had this whole thing lined up. The first thing I was going to do was overwritten, and the second thing I was going to do was overwritten.
Yeah, uh-huh. Be quick on the jaw.
You're doing something.
I mean, I would have hit the bandit with a different spell if you hadn't have killed him, because I'd be able to move 5 feet up, and then say this is your last chance to run away, and then he'd take extra damage if he actually did move away.
And what are you investigating, Yurik?
The cart and so many other knights to see if they had anything else important on them.
Knights are just going to have armor, a sword, and shield. The cart does have coin, though.
Beautiful, I'll be taking that.
And I'll be looking over the Templar Knights to find out stuff like cause of death or anything like that.
Very well.
Would that also be an investigation check? And also, should I hit the end turn button? Because my turn's been over for a long time now.
Yes, please. May I for a response? Yurik?
Oh, yes, I'm sorry.
Haha.
Lovely.
So one of them, the one that you're currently looking, have you rolled yet?
What do you want me to roll? Investigation, medicine, perception?
Just investigation will do.
Well, that's pretty apt for me.
To you, it looks as if they have been killed with demonic black... what's it called? Oh my fucking god. English, please. Demonic divine energy. There. In other words, corrupted... In other words, corrupted divine energy. But to anyone else that looks like sword slashers.
Interesting. What do you suppose they were trying to get from them?
You just think it's like the most... They've died by the most terrible, awful way to imagine. Why in reality, to everyone else, it is just sword slashers.
I was half expecting to be like, oh, you brought on that one. They still look alive.
That's your previous character.
Yeah, that's your previous character.
My previous character? They're wearing armor. No, they're not. They're wearing a berry.
Hang on. But one of the knights seems to have died pointing in a direction.
And I will point out that little area that I saw as we were going past them before as well. And I say there might be likely more of them up that way. And then I am going to move over to the next knight and take a look at their injuries.
This one seems to be actually hit with necrotic energy.
And assuming no one else
is slowly turning to ash.
And assuming no one else is actually doing anything, I would go over to the third body and look at that as well.
Again, looks like he is turning to ash. No, just turning to ash.
I want to check the ash.
Yeah.
Might have magical.
It gets blown away in the wind. It's turning to ash. And plus, you don't know about it, so have fun.
So what if I had a certain glass vial?
Then yes, you'd be able to collect the ash.
I wouldn't do that on this character.
I didn't think you would.
They dissolve into ash. I'm sorry, this berry can't dissolve.
Oh, fuck off. My god.
So, does anyone else react when I point out the part?
Oh, probably
I guess we all would react, wouldn't we?
Can I check what's in the cart?
That summary has it's now empty.
Must miss that bit.
What do we think they were after?
Your mother.
I'm talking in game.
They said the Saintess. They said the Saintess was kidnapped. Can I check the You didn't check the Holy Knight's bodies for any information.
But there is a path that's leading off into the distance.
I mean, if the bodies are ash, there isn't anything left to search.
Was the only, I thought only one body went to ash.
Who did? Only this one remains solid.
And I swear to God, if you're like, I loot his body, it's like, mm-mm.
No, I'm not going to loot it. I'm just going to search it, see if he had any information on him. Any. Not actual loot.
Guys, I'm going to be AFK for a second, all right?
Okay.
Sure.
Thanks.
You get struck by lightning and die.
You can just leave that to me.
So what do you do?
Shall we follow this path?
I would absolutely like to.
Let's go find us a Saintess.
Sounds like fun.
Try and escape if you must.
Don't give him that type of dare.
Can't. Try.
Now the group knows I can cast spells.
Give me one sec. Ah, shit. I'm clicking wrong things. Hold on.
Wow, no one made the joke this time.
That would be quiet.
I mean, we don't want to be repetitive.
You know, you got a point there. It zooms me out so far. Is this supposed to be pitch black in here?
It is a cave.
Oh, it's a cave.
Yes, the path leads to a cave, mahaha.
Oh, I see somebody up ahead.
Do you, though?
Papa?
I think if that's any indication.
Hey, I'm back. What did I miss?
You've arrived at a cave.
Oh, goody! Sorry, I had to get some grub.
Yeah, that's fair.
So do we do any type of marching order here?
I will allow that to be decided now, if you wish.
Well, someone's already went to move.
Well then.
No, I was just checking, because it's all grayscale for me. So I was weirded out for a moment.
Yeah, because that's why. That's what... Because dark vision is grayscale. You can't see colors with dark vision.
I know that. It just weeded me out for a moment. So I had to check.
Wait, do you have...
You're gonna ask if I have dark vision mode on? Yes, I do.
Oh, so you're currently seeing it all grey too, okay.
Yeah.
I can see in colour, but then that's me.
No, I just didn't set it to dark vision for you.
Okay.
No, so actual then, fact.
How are we going to get into this?
The one person who's blind gets to see in all colour. That's about fitting.
Well, at least we know he's not colour blind.
What if I wanted to go back in black and white?
No, he's just normal blind.
Yeah, guys, I'm normal blind, not color blind.
Well, do you guys have a marching order of sorts? Or is it just whoever goes in first goes in?
Oh, I guess Katron.
Should we go and roll for initiative and then try and clear this cave as quickly as possible? Speedrun it?
Yes.
Yes. Speedrun.
Let's do that.
Speedrun strats.
Speedrun! Hey,
what'll we do?
Hold on, let me get the chain.
For the speedrun, would we also be doing like total clear or just mission?
Ooh, that'd be interesting. Should we 100% speedrun or quickly as possible?
Or any percent
speedrun. Or any percent.
I think we should.
I mean, that'll all depend on what's in here, to be honest. If it's more bandits, I mean, I'd just say kill them all.
So at the moment, we're a blind 100% speedrun.
Yeah.
Hold on. Okay. You mean, should I show you the initiative rolls? Because I'm going to roll every NPC in here now as well.
Actually, nah. I mean, but we can see that one. He got a 21.
Oh, yeah, you can see that one. That's so many. Oh, God.
Yeah, it's there, right?
What the heck? Why do I have a high one again?
Yeah, so you want to roll yours?
Yep.
Do I get a free roll? I'm stuck at zero.
Wait, did you roll a zero?
Yes.
Oh my god. Oh my god. None of us have ever gotten a zero.
Here's minus one.
Oh my god, no. Oh, how the heck am I getting two 20s in the last two initiatives? This is not right.
I don't have enough room. Hold on. Alright. We're in combat. Combat has begun! Technically. So you will be having combat movement for this entire speedrun.
Nice.
Oh, terrific.
God, I believe this speed what's been posted to the Discord.
What's been posted to the Discord?
I don't see anything posted in the Discord.
Have you guys not seen that yet?
No. Oh my god, that is
for it now.
I've seen it since it appeared on there. I just assumed you all saw it but didn't say anything.
What?
So oh yeah. I'll show you this monster though.
Just casually pulls out a Tarrasque.
I got a 20.
How many 20s? What is this?
You don't understand,
what
man.
What is going on?
That's how a sweet chest.
Alright, well, I guess I go in first, I guess?
That's up to the group.
Yeah, you're first.
You're first.
Well, technically the cultist.
Yeah, what do you want to do?
I guess go in? I don't know, I've never gone a 20 before.
I mean, I think the cultist would have to end turn first.
Yeah.
Free movement, they are.
Alright, well, I guess I'm going in. Alright. What the heck? Just move me in. Yeah, about there. Aha!
Are you actually going to shout aha?
Oh, no, no, no.
He's dissolved into the wall.
Ooh. Hey, guys, you may want to come in here.
Do you say that out loud?
Yep.
Okay. Back to normal movement. He is now taking notice to you.
My turn now?
Yeah. Allow you guys to move in. But now you'll be able to attack. Because he's now taking notice of you.
I mean, will you allow me to move in? Well, that's more movement than what I've got, sir.
How much movement do you have?
I'm a halfling. I'm like 2 feet tall.
It's Navicultus' turn. Because of initiative. You guys want to roll initiative now?
I mean, it's a good thing. We'd be rolling for it immediately.
Fair enough.
Who's he going?
Since you would be the one that walked in first, he's going to go for you.
Damn it! Hey, buddy, how's it going?
We're all going to die.
I'll probably die.
Oh, well, that's what you got the healing potions for.
True.
You take 5 points of damage.
Now
it's Brick's turn!
It's...
Where are you, matey? You're there. Okay.
It's on, buddy.
What is this? That's a hit.
What is happening? What is actually happening?
Is that two nat 20s?
Can I take my dice back?
That is my, I've had like 4 20s.
What the actual... in a row.
What the heck is going on?
So, we know that this guy is dead, right?
Is he?
And then I can do sneak attack because everyone else, I've got players around me. Yes, I'm just trying.
Yes.
I can't.
Yes.
I can never remember that.
Is everyone a swashbuckle?
No.
No.
Only I am.
Alright, and that's my turn.
Okay.
My turn.
No, it's not.
Oh!
So this guy's
turn. There's another bandit.
I mean, what chaos would have been the second one moving in? Unless we just basically all moved in at once, and this is just where we happened to end up.
Pretty much. Actually, he's not going to move right up next to you.
How would?
Move there.
How? What range does he have?
He. Hold on, how much is this?
Because the attack animation. Nash. Yeah, the attack animation was on Nash, which.
Disadvantage. And I will.
Crossbow. That makes sense.
Who was that target at? Sorry, I lost.
You didn't hit you.
Ah. Yeah, that was at you, Nash.
Now it's chaos.
Okay. Unarmed strike.
Oh no!
What is with my roll today?
You haven't gotten a zero. You don't get to say that.
Yeah, but I haven't gone high either.
Have you gotten a zero?
Okay.
Well,
no. Yes, keep in mind, you are still relatively a newbie.
Oh, absolutely.
Hold on.
I could be killed at any time with no interaction with the story.
That's the end of my turn.
Yep.
My move.
No, you are our ace.
It is not your move yet. Next.
Beautiful.
Now it's your turn.
Boop. Gonna go here.
That's a lot.
Tug at this guy.
Nah, there's a lot. Keep in mind, everything is on the initiative order. You just can't see it.
That's definitely going to be a hit with a 24.
What do you mean that's going to be a hit?
Mouse too high.
Yeah.
Such a shame I haven't gone into champion yet. Otherwise, that would have been a crit. But that's going to be...
You know, a curious question. Is it still a crit if it's technically a miss?
Nat 20 auto hits. If it extends to 19, but it doesn't hit, then no. Then it doesn't hit.
You...
Yay! Luckily for me, I have, fighting stuff.
This is why you're our spearhead.
Yep. 21 to hit?
Yeah, seriously, without you, we'd be dead already.
7 points of damage.
I like all these combats are going to end without me actually getting to do anything.
Well, keep in mind, Chaos didn't exactly succeed, so he's in the same boat as you.
Yeah.
Yeah, but there's still another character to get through before my turn comes up.
Yeah, well, that's technically still Patreon. 10, 15...
20.
I'm gonna loot them real quick, if that's allowed.
I mean, it's not your turn. You're assuming we're staying in turn order?
Yes.
Okay.
So, yeah, that'd be me.
But, Mushu!
Mushu's gonna go up to here and also loot, this one right below him.
And this is the perfect way to make sure Chaos doesn't get anything, because I'm next.
Exactly. So, that'll be an investigation?
Yes, please.
Well, you guys should get something because you and Mushu didn't loot anything from the.
I wasn't there, so. Like, you did the entire dungeon. I only came into the very end. So, rightfully so, I shouldn't get anything from that.
Beautiful. And that would be the end of Mushu's turn.
Okay.
Everybody else.
Yeah. Okay, now your turn.
Yay. Investigation on the other body, because I might as well. If I'm going to be slow at something, I might as well, you know, take up the rear. That's about right.
Just the obvious stuff.
That one corporal almost seems like an insult. Okay, so let's move to a little bit of vision. First 10 feet to here. And is that even movable in there?
Apparently so.
Now I'm seeing double of myself.
Oh, that's weird.
I can't target my character model anymore.
Yeah,
there's two of it for me.
He has an evil twin.
Oh, there's two of you? Okay, give me one sec.
Oh no, we died.
Oh no, we went to hell.
Oh, we've been revived.
Okay, now I wouldn't be able to make it there.
I'm putting you there because otherwise it won't be able to sit properly.
Okay, well that's a turn and half my next turn's movement as well then.
I just go with it. Brick.
Alrighty, well, I don't know why I'm doing this, but I'm actually gonna just roll for stealth just for the heck of it. Eh. Alright. Ah, damn.
No stealth for you.
Well, in that case, I'll just use my movement.
I mean, at this point, you might as well just use your dash.
That's true.
Yep, so you're going to use dash?
Yeah, I'll just use dash.
Okay, so you have, what, 60?
Yeah, double your regular movement.
That'd be, that's 35, so that'd be 70.
Where do you want to move?
Just put in front, just right, it just in front of Nez.
So there?
Yeah, about there.
Okey-doke.
It didn't move. There we go.
It didn't move? There I am! Then I guess... Yeah, I think I'll just end my turn from here. I don't really know what else to go. I'll wait for you guys, so I end my turn.
You didn't even need to dash up to there.
Well, hey.
Hold on. Which one are you?
What is this? Hey, Nez, can you see the abyss on the other side of the wall?
I can see there's been a flying dagger that's come at me.
No, like, outside of the cave system.
Oh, yeah, I can now.
Yeah, we can see into the abyss.
It's calling.
That does not hit you.
Does it hit me?
No.
Hold on, jackals?
Oh, jack all that.
Oh, go and jack off.
Hey, don't tell that to me. Tell it to them. They're the jackasses.
Chaos.
Yeah?
How many trays they've mastered.
Okay. I'm gonna dash.
He's dashing through the snow.
Are you dashing too? Yeah. Just hover where you want to end up.
Well, first I'm gonna... Yeah, I'm gonna head here.
I think you're running straight into a wall there.
Yeah, you will be.
That's a wall, really, and I'm assuming that
see
the...
Now, can I?
Okay, that's also in a wall. The wall ends on my little mark a bit here.
Yeah, so around here.
Yeah. Then I probably won't need to dash. I could just head here.
Yeah, I didn't even have to move it for you.
You know, I somehow duplicated my model, so...
Because two people move at once.
Yeah, that's my turn. Nothing much I can do. Alright. I keep forgetting that I need to press that.
Okay. I don't have to worry about them anymore.
Oh no, another jackoff. Jackass.
Yeah. Hey Chaos, at least now you're higher than a monster now.
Yeah.
When am I gonna be higher than a monster?
When it's a minus two.
Your turn, Caitron.
Beautiful.
Join us.
30.
Become one.
That will result in you passing an entity.
Yeah, I just realized that. So I most likely would have stopped here.
Knock a knock.
Yeah.
Pull Mushu up the back. Is that guy?
He's like, Papa, wait for me.
Go ahead and target.
Look. Does Mushu consider you a papa?
Absolutely not.
Absolutely, yes.
Well, I know he considers you the weird uncle.
Turn to hit.
That will be a miss.
Okay, bonus action. That one. Oh, wow. Okay.
What the heck?
That would also be a miss.
That would be the end of my turn.
You mean I can hit something?
This is your chance to shine.
If Mushu doesn't kill it first.
Oh no. Are we just gonna have to take one each?
Maybe that's how many I put in there.
We hit a hornet's nest and this is what we get.
Oh, definitely.
I think that'd be more terrifying.
Well, it's a metaphor. But yeah, hitting an actual hornet nest would be even worse.
Hock it up.
Alright.
You can hit something.
Yay! Part of this spell casting for this cantrip, I'm going to draw my sword and then I'm going to swing it at the one directly in front of me. Do I need to hit the target thing to target?
It's just T.
I don't know why that rolled with advantage.
I mean, either way, I think it's a hit. We'll succeed.
15, 19. But I don't know why it did that.
DM?
It'll hit either way.
It hits either way.
It just means you wasted an extra dice.
I mean, that's fine. Okay, this is a situational, same formula. So the one in front of me will take 10 points of damage, and the one directly next to that, because of the extra effect on that, will take 3 points of fire damage. Now, do I want...
Whoa!
Oh,
okay,
that was easy.
They have very little hit points.
Do I wish to move up is the next question, isn't it?
Well, it depends. Do we want to go up or down?
I
can see
there.
More coming in. Does anyone have ranged attacks?
I've got a longbow.
I have a spell.
I am very close range.
I wish you had fireball.
Yeah, then I will move here, and then I'll end my turn here.
Alright. Well, I'm actually gonna use my longbow this time, so... Alright. Damn it. Alright, well, it's been a while since I've rolled a small roll, so I'm happy with the rolls I've gotten so far. That's a miss, boss.
That's a positive thing to think about it.
Yeah. Alright, well then I end my turn.
And your turn ends you.
Oh, come on. I've been rolling good. So far. I'm actually not complaining.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, that was a miss.
Someone else please take damage. I don't want to be just the only one that has damage.
Oh, well.
No.
Oh, I'll just say that if I start taking damage, you should probably be worried.
Yep.
Yeah.
Nah.
Thank you for the hail. Cat.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna move to here.
Thank you for the hail.
That was a what? Oh. Then I'm going to attack this guy. With a...
Don't forget to target.
Where is it? I have targeted.
You have indeed. Sorry, I didn't see that map
thing. Oh, you're aiming for the far one, okay.
Yeah, get that one out the way. I'm gonna use Sacred Flame.
Sacred Flame!
They may please roll a dexterity saving throw. I don't trust myself to roll high enough to hit it.
Well, I rolled low, so maybe you can roll high.
I've made it public, so you know if they've hit or missed.
Yay. So damage. Normal. Oh shit.
You're still struggling.
Sucked. Yeah, that's.
Hey, it's still damage. Look at it that way. It's still damage.
It is still damage.
True.
Oh, whoa, okay, I got perfect.
Wait, what?
Hold on.
Where are you guys?
We were pushed through the wall. Through the wall.
I got sucked into the abyss.
Oh, fuck. Hold on.
We got... we glitched through the wall.
God was looking at me like, ah, I don't like these two, let's just send them away.
Yeah, that was a glitch. I don't know what happened.
Yeah.
Sucked into a black hole.
It would seem so.
Being and Nez are the only survivors.
I can survive anything. Unless it's initiative.
Oh no, they have pack tactics!
Come on, we gotta pack some heat, fellas.
Now, do I use my reaction?
Not needed.
Okay, then.
You should save it for later, is what I'm implying. Hey, Sean.
Oh, so it is my turn. Let's go... Move over here, target this one, hit them with my main action.
Ooh.
10.
Miss.
Bonus action. 19!
Oh, I'm sorry, but that is a hit.
All hail the ace in the hall.
That's right, fuck you.
Well, almost right now three looks sixes. Like you're dead.
It was almost three sixes.
Chaos?
Yeah.
I think we should start worshipping a new god.
Who?
Who do you think? The one that just is the one that gets the best rolls and has the most attacks out of all of us.
You sure?
Yeah. Wait until I get my multi attack, and then they can attack three times.
Oh god.
Two.
Oh, let's see. And you have the best rolls when it comes to damage as well.
I mean, I could say wait until I get quick, and so I too can cast two spells.
Alright. Well, what's the little mushroom boy do?
Good question. Thirteen to hit. Yeah. Beautiful. That's gonna be end to the one's turn.
Mm-hmm. Nez.
Alright, well, we've started moving down here. Might as well continue.
He's going down.
What can I hear around me?
Absolutely nothing.
Okay, so then I will take a dash then.
Oh, he's disappeared.
I'm stopping there.
Very well.
Brick.
I'm going to try, and it's Sage. Thank you. We need to change that. Like, at least, like, my name is a Meta Sage now, or at least call me Sage.
Oh, you mean the good shit?
I'm just going to try my luck at a stealth roll again, so... Alright, that's not too bad. That's better. And then... Oh. Thanks, demon.
You're welcome.
And then I guess I... Hold on. Can I take my dash action again? I really need to memorize all the things in that in here.
Dash action requires your action.
Well,
since we're playing an initiative...
Well, I can use cunning.
Oh, yeah. And plus, you do have your rogue ring. So you can use it as a bonus action.
Ooh. All right. Well, I'll dash myself to where Nez went to. Which way did he go to?
I went down south.
All right. So, hold on. 30, 30, 40. And then I think I can go a little more because double, that's about 70. So 40. I can go another 30 feet.
So when it gets into red, that's when you go past dash.
Yeah. Alright.
Orange is dash.
Alright, 40, 10. And I'll probably park it about...
Well, yeah, there's a wall there. There's a wall there.
Yeah, I can't see.
You go here.
Hit.
And then and then down.
And then I will stop here.
Yeah.
And I don't hear anything either down here.
It is a dead end.
It is a dead end? Alright.
Yes.
Well, at least my dash was good for something, so I will end my turn.
Turn around.
Hey,
turn around again, down.
Also, just wondering, can they, everyone else see me in stealth?
You select the target of which you want to hide from.
Well, I'm not trying to hide from you guys, except maybe Chaos.
So, yeah, we'll be able to see you.
Rude. Fair.
Hey, you admit it. And yeah. It's your turn, Chaos.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna head down here. I'm not even gonna bother looting the jackal.
That's a shock.
I mean, what would they have on them?
I mean, they have their hide.
Can't see anything from here, so I think I'm just going to end my turn there.
Very well.
Yeah, can't see a thing further on, so don't want to risk a dash either.
Very well. Petron!
So Sage went down and to like here, right?
Here actually. Hold on, what's going on? Here actually.
Okay. So all of this is a dead end, or?
That's all I can see. I can't see anything past.
Okay. I'm gonna go in with a cunning action.
I'm pretty sure that's going to be going through a wall as well.
Yeah, so I think the wall's like around down here.
That is a dead end.
Yeah, there's also a dead end.
So two dead ends down here, so it must be upwards we have to go.
Do you really think I would put the captured being at the very start?
Hey, we agreed.
Well, I think you put something down here, like maybe it's like little bits and bobs, you know, maybe just some fabrics, maybe a couple old weapons and some
maybe
cash,
a secret passage to head deep into the cave, who knows?
Yeah. At this point you should know by now we're gonna explore everything.
Maybe some fresh dirt for some more worms.
That is true.
Some stone to worms. Oh my god.
Oh, maybe Cass can start a book on Worminology.
Worminology.
Yeah, if he sells it, he'll get money for it.
Once I start having fire elemental worms, earth elemental worms, water, lightning, wind, holy, demonic, so on and so forth.
We'll start with the basic collection and then write the first few chapters.
Now, I'll first need to breed all these different worms and then start writing the book.
Well, it's too bad that Catron can never read it.
Yeah, sure. Unless it's such a shame.
Unless it's for Braille.
You're making a mistake here. In the very beginning, he could still read books even though he's blind. He was our library keeper, remember?
Well, somehow he, with his blindness, he can convert anything into Braille so he can read it.
Or should we just end?
He's blind, but not illiterate.
I may be blind, but I am a scholar. I have some skill.
Okay. Does anyone call that they're dead ends down there?
Yeah, it looks like dead ends over here.
Yep, same.
Okay, then I am gonna start heading back. And I might as well take the dash action because I took the dash action to get down here. And let's end there. One of these times we're gonna like fly past and be like, oh, hold on, let me reverse all that.
Nash.
Sorry, I was just reading. I guess.
What, your biography?
No, I was just reading through. I was just reading through all my armor features because I was just trying to work out what else I could do.
So your biography.
And I don't have the thing straight up. Hold on, I'll get on my screen so I now know when it's my turn. Alright, I guess I'll do an action surge again, so... let me just...
Oh, you don't really need... Right. Can you use an action surge to double dash?
Hold on.
This is
never mind.
Patron and Neza.
Technically, we can double dash if we use a bonus action and a main action.
Yeah, I don't think it dashes once per turn.
Apparently, I'm just reading it now. I have to have a short rest before I can use Action Surge again.
Yep.
But that means with Action Surge and Cunning Action, you can triple dash.
Well, I mean, I can just do my regular, and then do
Action
and then
Surge.
Use...
You have to use your action for an attack.
Oh, is it?
Charge attack.
Yeah.
You have cunning action, which lets you dash as a bonus action.
Well, I'll just move my amount of feet I can go.
You can dash as a main action as well.
Oh, well. I'm sorry. Am I doubling? If I'm dashing, I'm doubling it. Yes.
Yes.
All right. Hold on. So
until it becomes red.
All right. So that was at least 55. Let's go up here. Then I'll go here.
Mm-hmm.
And you said until it becomes red, so I can't. I'll probably leave you there. Then I'll use my cunning action. So that's what, another 70 feet?
It should be another 35.
Not 35. Well, it's not letting me. Do I have to actually go on the thing to use it?
Hold on. Hi now.
Alright, so that's another 35, so...
You're running into a wall, mate.
I know. Cheers. And I'll stop there.
That's where you are now, is as far as you can move.
Yep, and since I'm in stealth, like, I'm assuming could these fellas potentially see me, or?
Give me one sec. I do not believe they should be able to, no.
Alright, that should be it, so now I end my turn.
Chaos.
Yeah.
It's your turn.
Yep. I'm gonna go here. Oh, wait, let me. There. Then there. Oh, I'm pressing the wrong button. That was it. I'm gonna dash for this.
Okay.
When we hit the December month, every time we say dash, we have to start singing Dashing Through the Snow.
Dashing save it for Christmas.
I know, that's what I said. Save it for December.
Dashing
got Halloween
through the
first.
Enemies in a bloodshed open space.
Can you stop touching your tokens?
Cutting everyone.
Okay. Thank you.
And that's the end of my turn.
Patron.
Beautiful. Let's go with.
Dashing.
Yeah, that's with the first.
Wait, how much movement do you have?
I have 30, then I can dash, then I can double dash.
Ooh, I think tracking's messed up.
Yeah. So that'll be 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80. And that'll be it for my turn. For Mushu?
Can you guys see what I see?
Yeah, I can see two of them.
Who's the bandit going for?
That is always a good question.
Like, because I don't think they can see me.
Can't you see who I'm targeting?
Oh, I had to zoom in to see it because it's right on top of. I'm right on top of it.
Up to here. Let's target it. I can't get in there. So right. Let's throw another chill touch at him.
So if you just hover and click T on your keyboard, it's the target.
I hit the target button in the turn order. Easy way to do it.
Oh, that just pings it.
Okay, so it's a normal roll. It's not cheating with advantage or anything like that.
Oh no, if you hover over the initiative order, then you can just go in and target them. Just press T1 the Yeah, that's nice.
Does a 15 hit this bandit?
Yes, a 15 hits this bandit.
Ooh. Okay, that's going to be 1 point of necrotic damage. And that's the end of my turn.
Alright. I'm going to move up behind this guy. Oh.
You sure you want to move?
And keep my gnashes in stealth.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Yeah, trust me, I'm not making the same mistake last time. Alright, I'm hopping up there. Oh, that looks weird on my screen. What's going on there? And then I'll attack this guy. Short sword. Alright. And I get advantage because I'm stealthed.
Yep.
Alright. That's a miss, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah, well, better than that one. And then I guess I'll end my turn there then.
I'm going to show you this.
You got... Oh, no, you got that 20. This is the opposite of what I was thinking.
I knew the risks when I was on stealthing. I knew the risks. But seriously, why is it that I keep taking damage?
Why is it that you're the one only getting hit?
Seriously.
Points of damage.
I think it's because he's the only one rolling high. It's calm.
No, but I've never rolled high and I get more damage.
Because you're the one that keeps walking in front of everyone.
Well, I stealthed and I knew the risks when I made that gamble.
Why are you complaining?
I'm not complaining. I'm just like, why is it always? Why aren't you guys taking any damage?
That sounds like complaining.
I'm not complaining. I want to share the pain.
As someone who has like 25 feet of movement, you can always outrun me. That's why.
Yeah, well, I'm pretty sure all of you have a higher armor class than me.
Oh, absolutely.
This guy. There we go. Finally. Would he be in range for my short sword?
Yes.
5 feet.
Come on, Chaos!
Let's see how bad a roll this is.
Will be a miss.
A miss?
So, a good way to remember thing is like...
thoughts there.
How do I... That is not what I want.
As long as it's...
Here.
Like in the 9 squares.
So, yeah, so, kind of like this. So, like, what's around you?
In that.
Pretty much, yep.
Okay. I need to roll a different thing next time.
Maybe you should just, like, physically roll a dice, see if there's a difference.
Gonna go move up to here. Attack with my main action.
What is happening?
That is a mess.
Attack with bonus action. That's even worse.
Oh no.
That's the end of my turn.
Did I take all of your control?
Yes, you did.
Before we continue. I'm gonna try something, see if this fixes our rolls.
Did I take all your good rolls?
There we go, our roll should be better now.
I've cleared chat.
I mean, typically, right. to get better rolls, you need to change your color.
True, but I don't think we can change color.
Let's
That is better.
That is a hit.
Nice. Roll for damage, and then for sneak attack. Mushu got killed!
Mushu's done it!
First blow.
5, 10, 15, 20...
Hey, Mushu, how's it going?
Can't do an offhand attack with a ranged weapon. Okay, I believe that'll be it for Mushu.
Oh my god, this combat tracker is getting smaller.
Yeah, that'll be 25.
Okay. Let's throw another chill touch at the cultist. Thank God I have a ranged spell.
Just don't hit me.
That is a hit.
A natural 20.
It's still 1 point of damage.
I mean, I'll take it. It's still damage. It's unhealable too. Movement, attack, and turn.
Alright, well, let's try my luck again. Although I'm contemplating whether or not to use one of those potions.
No, take out the enemy in front of you, then you can take the potion.
Yeah, well, let's see if I can. I don't know if I can.
Come on, you can do it.
I don't know, because I think now that we reset, my rolls might be crap again.
We may never know.
Alright, come on. Alright, here we go. Alright, so...
It still hits.
Yep. Alright. And, okay. And.
Snake attack, no one's... 5 feet.
Pardon?
Snake attack, 5 feet.
Oh, I'm not within 5 feet, so I'm ending
There's
the turn.
There's an ally within 5 feet of your enemy, so you gain sneak attack.
Oh, okay. I thought it was with them in 5 feet of me. I don't know why. I always get it mixed up in my head. All right, come on. Give me something good. Give me something good. All right, that's pretty good. And can I heal myself with one of my potions? Or is that just my turn?
I'll allow it.
Goody.
Normally a good rule is that you can heal yourself with a healing potion as a bonus action, but it's an action to heal somebody else with a healing potion.
That is depending on DM, though.
Yeah, that is true. But it's a good rule to have.
I mean, at 5.5, it's de facto bonus action for any type of potion.
Do I just press on it and use it?
Yep.
Is that how it works?
Yes.
Alright, use.
4 die 4 plus 4. Oh no.
Oh, that's a greater healing. Okay.
I pressed it once. Why?
Okay, stop.
I'm stopping.
Thank you. I now have to re-add an item.
Huh?
I'm gonna actually add 2 to your inventory because I'm gonna do it for you.
That's probably a good idea.
Use. And then. Heal. Public. Normal. When we click use item, it will still ask us to click the roll button in chat.
Okay.
So you can may take that healing.
Alright, that's 14. Alright. Hold on. 10.
You click apply, my friend.
I'm just working. Oh, it heals me right up properly.
Yes. You can just click apply.
Yeah. You right click on the tag that says 14 plus 4, 14. And then it will say...
Apply health.
Yeah, apply health.
Yeah.
There we go.
Yay! I'm back to full strength again. Now, I'll end my turn.
Apply double damage.
Chaos.
You want to loot the body?
Yep.
You can loot the body.
Not this time.
Wow.
Right, he's refusing to loot a body.
No, I will.
I was going to say that was some character.
He's looting the other one. Okay.
I was just going to say he could have made his character arc, but nope.
I'm only looting one of them. I'll leave the other one to Catron.
Ah, thank you.
Thank you.
More items to sell.
And now I'm going to go here.
Oh, I see two more bandits off in the distance.
How do you see? Oh, Mushu. How does Mushu see that?
Because you've given Mushu dark vision.
But Mushu should only have dark vision around him.
I know, it's weird, right?
I mean, I can't
for
see
some
anything
reason, out there. No, for some reason, I see it. Catron sees that from here.
How do you see it?
What's... I have no clue.
How are you seeing it? Can anyone else see anything?
Chaos.
Yeah, I can see them.
I can't see anything.
I'm so confused.
Anyway, let's go investigate this body.
Investigate the body.
Oh, that is good.
What are we thinking? Are we thinking after we wrap up this, we call it a shop for today?
I'm gonna go like another hour, what do you mean?
Oh, sorry, man, I can't. If I could, I would. Oh, jeez!
He's doing Lethal Company after this.
Yes.
What if we are the Lethal Company?
Well, after this, I don't know, I'm probably just gonna do Switch stuff.
Switch stuff?
Switch.
So you gotta go and play the Switch?
Yes.
So you have nothing important.
Oh no, but I have to prep for tomorrow. Okay, I'm a working class citizen.
I also have work tomorrow.
How have I still, claimed the top of the,
why
turn list?
Why is Mishu staying on top of you?
That is a good question.
Should I move back so you can fix that?
No, I can separate them.
I did not see them there. They were not there before.
Another glitch, I would say.
Yeah.
Do you guys see that weird glitch off, in the corner? Where it's just, lines?
Yeah, it's based on perspective and how not all of the lines are met up properly. It's probably around about here and here.
I see all around there, yeah. Well, what the heck? Now I can see the enemies.
Yeah, there's gaps in the wall there, so I can see through it.
Well, before I couldn't see them, now I can.
But they're connected.
Out here.
Here, let me fix that for you. There's now no more.
Okay, is 14 a hit?
Which one are you hitting?
If it doesn't have the target one, it'd be that one in the front. with a chill touch.
So that will be it.
Yeah.
Three points, I'm going up.
Hey, you're doing a bit more damage.
Hey, he's done it.
Movement.
Yeah. Alright, here we go. Okay. Frack. Alright, I'm gonna go. Yeah. Oh, wait, hold on. I'm not quite there. Then here. And then.
Poor Bandit.
He made his.
He did nothing wrong. But be a Bandit.
I think I'll attack the other one.
Poor cultist. He did nothing wrong besides being a cultist.
It's not like anything happened, so. End turn.
I was gonna say, it's like, poor Bandit, well then he got banned from it.
I think that would only apply if one of us played a bandit and then we actually got banned. Why do I put myself in peril?
I don't know.
I think all those high rolls have gone to my head.
You think?
Chaos.
Yep.
Sorry, my mind's just not processing right now. I should probably get closer.
I mean, it might be a good idea.
I want to hit him with the sword, then yes, I need to get closer. Watch this be less than 10.
Oh!
You're saying?
Damn.
How'd that
happen? That is a hit.
It's because you're next to me, because I've got him good 20s, you're next to me.
If only the damage's better.
I mean, 5 isn't bad.
True.
Well, I mean, there's 5 of us, so how can it be?
Yes.
It could be worse. I'll somehow roll 0 for damage.
Oh yeah, it's me and Chaos versus them now.
You're fucking with me, right?
What?
Net 20?
Oh no. Well, hopefully he doesn't get too high. I take back what I said.
Ooh.
I mean, there's an upside.
You take 11 damage.
Me?
Yes.
There is an upside to this.
Hey, you haven't been the only one to take damage.
Yeah, hey, I'm not the only one that took damage now. Thank you, Chaos.
You're welcome. That just took a third of my health.
Well, then you've got more health than me, apparently.
Well, when I got hit, that was half my health.
Oops.
Oh.
I'm gonna be nice. That will be a miss.
As I fucking hope so.
You are a beast.
Never judge a man by his perception.
Well, can I judge you via perception check?
Never judge a man by his inability to see.
That looks like it takes a lot of skill.
It's all that's missing is a couple of batons and a devil costume.
Damn you, references.
I'm sorry, that's how I see you at this point.
Of course.
Oh. Yes, indeed.
My move.
Everyone got that reference, right?
No.
Yes. Chaos, you got that reference?
You won't be able to move there since I'm technically blocking that path.
Yeah, that's true. So, I'm gonna go and take out the new weapon that I picked up. Presumably it already has a bolt stacked in it, and fire it.
It will. Exactly one bolt.
Nice!
You get one shot.
The bandit attacks with their crossbow.
16 to hit.
That is a hit.
Since it's a ranged weapon, it counts as a sneak attack. That is cocked on my screen. Damn it. Yeah, 9 points of damage. I go in, point, bang! Dead on the spot. Yeah. Nah, I'm good. Mushu is gonna go. Probably here. Then squeeze on through.
Oh, okay.
Oh no, Mushu's dead. There's a skull over him.
Oh, he got revived.
10 doesn't.
No, it's a miss.
Yeah. Gonna go in offhand with a dagger. So this will be. Most likely a minus 2 to this roll, but it doesn't matter, it hits anyway. So that would just be a D4 points. Damage. And then sneak attack on top of that. Eight points. That's the
okay.
End of Mushu's turn.
Range attack boy, who's meant to be the tank.
Yeah, I know, right? It kind of feels like that way, doesn't it?
So, well, I mean, we're all supposed to be a lot of rolls, but we're not really filling him.
That's a hit.
That barely rolled at all.
Now, will he get higher hit points?
Hey, you're going up in the world.
Hey, he's doing it.
Yeah.
He's just powering up.
Hey. All
right. Well, I'm hoping I can finish this guy off.
Don't miss.
We'll see. That's definitely not a mess.
Are you sure about that?
Oh no, that's secretly the big boss of the whole campaign.
No. If he was the boss of the campaign, he would have phases.
And then just to wrap it up. Ah, never mind.
Never mind, you can use it on your next target.
Well, I mean, I can't really at the boat. I'll just roll anyway just to see what I would have gotten. Eh. I'm just making sure he's dead. Eh, then that will be my turn, then.
I have to spam so much. What's the fact?
That's your fault for having so many.
I wasn't expecting you to speed run up.
Expect the unexpected, my friend.
If you really want to see a speedrun, you'll take off the initiative tracker.
He'd need about six of him.
Oh, God, can you imagine doing actual real time, just all of us spamming attack rolls?
Chaos.
Yep, sorry. My brain just not functioning.
Well, brain we're nearly that structured.
Let's go with a spell. Fail. Oh, not bad. End of my turn.
Oops.
They really don't like you, Chaos.
Well, I need to move them back because that goes in my way.
No, they do not.
I'm currently out of bullets and mostly out of range stuff, so
and the whole room's filled up.
Yeah, let's go and throw a hand axe. This won't end terribly.
You hit one of us.
Oh no.
I knew it was gonna happen.
My, oh my.
Nez just took some damage.
Your hand axe hits the wall.
Does it get embedded into the wall?
Okay.
You would have to use strength to get it out, then yes.
Just gonna go and move over here.
Fair enough. Do you see anything up in that corner?
Nothing at the moment. So I'll just end my turn there.
Yeah. Would that not provoke an AOP from the bandit?
Technically, yes.
Yes, it would. So I will do that now.
That means everyone can rush past him because the reaction's been used.
We can shove him to the ground and run all over him.
We'll just get the tank to sit on him.
You know, I don't think they're going to be too into that.
Oh my god.
Motherfucker.
Oh no.
Well, you're not going to like this.
Nah, 20. Yeah,
luckiest
so.
Bandit alive. Holy shit.
He must have a good luck charm.
Oh my god. You would take 10.
Okay.
Oh my god, that is actually hilarious. How many 20s have I gotten today?
This is a very strange session, let's be honest.
It all started when I showed up.
You brought the chaos.
Okay, sure, don't forget to take the damage.
Yeah, I'm trying to, but it's not letting me allow me to, like, take it away from
you. I've done it for you.
Yeah.
Mushu!
He can get vengeance for you.
God fuck. Yes, yeah. Mushu.
Mushu!
I choose you.
Take his short sword. And do nothing with it. So instead, he's gonna take the dagger.
I feel like that short sword's about to get discarded.
Yes, apparently.
I'll say that hits.
Yep.
because he's number one.
Yeah, and I'm gonna do and do sneak attack into other.
He was at one health as well, you see. Yes.
Oh, he's just make, he's just pissed that he's just pissed for missing him with the first couple times.
Oh my god.
Man, you're not even halfway through yet.
Yeah. Oh, and it's only 3:20. 3 hours 20 of streaming.
Yeah, we are over time that we normally do.
Yeah.
Then we want to wrap up, finish here, unless people want to continue going.
Nah, don't you have a stream with friends to do?
That doesn't. I don't have to get in a call with them until 8.
I mean, we could just go to the top of the round if we're leaving then.
Yeah, that's true.
I say I'm the only one with a turn left.
Yeah, well, you can scout ahead for us or what? Rob a body, up to you.
15, 20. Don't see anything up ahead, loot the body.
Nice.
I mean, if I'm dashing forward, like in front of everyone, there's still two bodies back there to roll as well. You don't want me to roll?
Oh, yeah, roll. But you can also click accept.
Next time we're on, I'm rubbing the body in front of you.
Alright. So you get that. And that, what you obviously see them wearing. And you get
a magic ring.
No, not yet.
That's not bad.
And it looks right. Like the end of the session.
Yes, combat. The combat tracker will keep plays, so we can immediately pick up where we left off.
Hey.
Alrighty. Alright.
Will Nash's luck continue?
Oh, I
don't know.
Will the bandits get even tougher?
Another thing, I don't know.
Let's be honest, like, this has been my best session for dice rolls. Like, since
actually, yeah, fair. Yeah.
Do the bandits worship the god of luck? Will they see more nat 20s?
Will I actually get a decent hit?
Will Nez get more than a 0 on initiative?
Find out next time on the Tale of Lost Souls.
I will be probably streaming Lethal, which I don't have to actually get to, like, half now.
All I heard was all hail, and it's just a massive bird screech in the background.
I think the bird wants to become the new god.
Bird has come to challenge god.
Alright. So. Yes, I have to. I guess I have to waste time for half an hour.
Read some manga. So you're going to stay streaming for a bit?
Yeah.
Oh, then in that case, I have an easy raid target.
I mean, well, if you're looking at wasting 30 minutes, I mean, have a drink, get some food, do clean up after food, have a shower, you're probably already over time there.
Yeah. Omega, you still in chat? Well, I'm still gonna be live, that's the thing. I'm just going straight into it. Omega, you here, or have you left?
Are you gonna do a mukbang on live?
Oh god. Jesus Christ.
What?
Nothing. I guess they have left, okay.
Yeah, it does look like it. Well, anyway, I'm going to be raiding Demon because I would need to head off.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
I'm
the only one in the house at the moment, so I have to take care of everything.
I will find something to do for 30 minutes.
Play a game or something.
Make sure to get your lethal mods up today. Make sure to get their lethal mods up
today. I did it before we even started D&D.
Yeah, but now you got to check and see if they've changed anything.
God damn it.
See you, Katron's chat for time being until Raid gets in here, I guess.
Yeah, that is true.
I don't know what to say.
Well, all in all, this is to me talking to my chat. Thank you, everybody else, for coming out. raiding demon, so things are not going to change much. Apart from that, I've been Katron. And I'm going to be raiding demon right now. Bye!
And we're back.
And we're back!